Skywatch Media News for September 24th, 2019. As our planet enters into the fall equinox, there still remains some big news revolving around an incident from the sky this past summer, and it has created quite a media frenzy. In late July, a record-setting asteroid came within just 40,000 miles of the Earth. This was the largest space rock to come this close to the planet in more than a century. The public would not have known about this close encounter if not for the release of internal NASA emails on this incident, emails which were obtained through a Freedom of Information request. According to the information that was gathered from the internal agency documents, NASA was caught completely by surprise on this one, as they had to admit that they failed to detect a huge incoming asteroid. Their admittance places grave concerns on their surveillance network and their ability to observe incoming space objects. The monster asteroid, dubbed 2019 OK, was spotted just 24 hours prior to its narrow miss with Earth. According to the email alert from NASA's Planetary Defense Office on July 24th, which was submitted to other space agency experts, in about 30 minutes' time, an asteroid of 57 to 130 meters in size will pass Earth at a distance of less than 48,000 miles. The huge asteroid approached the Earth at 55,000 miles per hour with very little warning, first detected on the same day by a small observatory located in Brazil. Because the asteroid approached from the dark side of the Earth, it should have been easily seen, and yet this space rock avoided detection. If the asteroid had disrupted the Earth's atmosphere upon its approach, it would have created a blast wave that would have flattened an area roughly 50 miles across. An impact of this proportion, had it occurred, would be similar to the Tunguska event that took place in Russia in the year 1908. The recent incident begs the question that many of you are asking now. How many times has a potentially dangerous asteroid passed the Earth without it being discovered prior to its passage? According to the space agency, more dedicated surveillance satellites with infrared telescopes are necessary in order to detect incoming space rocks years or even decades in advance, in order that they be deflected out of the Earth's path. A recent public affairs survey shows that near-Earth objects are capturing our attention. It seems we are far more interested in placing the focus on potential impacts rather than devoting time to the exploration of Mars or returning to the Moon. NASA admits that asteroid 2019 OK is the largest rock to pass this close to the Earth in the past 100 years. But they insist that nothing this big will pass this close again until the approach of Apophis in the year 2029. Only time will tell if their predictions are correct. The number of reported incoming meteors and fireballs continues to increase. On September 20th, a very large fireball lit up the evening sky over Tasmania and Victoria, creating a thunderous sound. Night turned to day as the blue and white streak of light suddenly turned red and orange upon entry into the atmosphere. Astronomers from the Queen Victoria Planetarium described the fireball entry as a significant event, something that is rarely observed. The object disintegrated in the atmosphere about 12 miles above the Earth's surface. The loud booming sound moments after the flash of light occurred as a result of the meteor exploding. The universe is in a perpetual transformation. This would include our own solar system. Indications point to the likelihood that the Earth, the Sun, and all planets are approaching a position in the galaxy known as the galactic core. This shift is, in essence, changing the magnetic field of the Sun and the planets of the solar system. Credible evidence shows that Earth is not the only planet that is undergoing transformational changes. Observational data indicates that Pluto is growing dark spots, that auroras are appearing on Saturn, polar transformation is occurring on Uranus, and Neptune is undergoing a form of light intensity. The planetary body Pluto resides in the cold darkness of the solar system near the Oort cloud. This is the coldest region of our solar system, and yet observations of Pluto indicate that it is heating up, where its atmospheric pressure has increased by 300%, the most of any planet in the solar system. Furthermore, the atmosphere of Pluto is changing as it travels further from the Sun, which then suggests that this body may have entered into the high-energy region of the galaxy, with the remainder of our solar system following close behind. So changes are definitely taking place across the solar system. The best evidence to date that this phenomenon is taking place resides with the Sun's magnetic field, which has increased by 230% just in the past 100 years. The Sun's energy intensification has created immense solar winds, which heightens the electrical charge across space. As the Sun's magnetic field strengthens, it attracts galactic dust elements located in the solar system. The amount of stardust in our solar system has tripled in just the past 15 years. This, in turn, is heating up the solar system. We are now witnessing great changes taking place in real time, and this theory, like others, provide additional clues which may further explain what's happening across our solar system and the galactic plane. The Sun has dimmed in 2019. Sunspot activity is presently at an all-time low for the year. It has now been blank for 72% of the time between January and September. This solar minimum is now considered a century-class event, meaning that you would have to go back to the beginning of the 20th century to find lulls in solar activity that are this long or this deep. Along with the diminished sunspots and the weakened magnetic field, cosmic rays are entering the solar system, producing increased solar winds which lash the Earth with cosmic materials, creating geomagnetic storms. It's possible that the present minimum could last indefinitely, a period of many decades, a phenomenon which last occurred back in the mid-17th century. If such an event repeated itself today, it would be devastating for life on Earth. As we look to our changing sky, be not dismayed. For the sky is something that we have very little control of, and the space beyond us is a place we do not fully understand. Thanks for watching.